SOLIDWORKS has provided us a sample exam, and in the beginning part of the sample exam, you'll actually have all the details about preparing for the exam and what's going to be on the exam. Now, the exam itself is going to be 3 hours and 30 minutes long, and you got to get at least a 75% grade on it. Now, it's going to be broken down into three segments. Unlike the CSWA exam that has to be taken all at one time, this one allows you to take each segment one by one. And if for some reason you don't pass a segment, you can go back and retake just that one segment. Now, the first section of this exam is going to be taking and modeling a part. It's going to be generally set up with a drawing that you're going to have to read the drawing and create the part off of that drawing. It's going to use heavy emphasis on using equations, linked values, and then making modifications to the original part you create multiple times. Segment two is going to be taking a part and creating configurations of that part, and then weighing the part or finding the center of mass. Segment three is going to be working inside of an assembly or multiple assemblies, adding parts, modifying the parts, creating mates, and then again weighing or finding the center of mass of that assembly. Most of the questions on the exam are going to build one on top of each other, so if you mess up the first part, you're going to mess up the second part. So you have to make sure that you get the right answers to each one of those, otherwise go back and make sure you correct your model and verify you're getting the correct answers or very close to what the multiple choice questions are. In fact, that's how most of the questions are set up, is the first one's going to be a multiple choice answer. So your answer should be one of those four. For some reason, if it's not one of those four, you've done something wrong and need to go back and correct yourself to make sure that yours is one of those answers, because the next question is going to be your free response asking you to weigh the part or find the center of mass. And if your model's not correct, no matter what you change in it, you're not going to get the second part of it correct. So making sure you have one of the multiple choice questions answered correctly is definitely going to be key to passing this exam. Now, as far as the skills, let's take a look at what's going to be involved here. We're going to be going through sketching, draft, shell. Now, this is basically how we've laid out this course. So we're going to cover all these basic skills. Then we're going to look at each individual section of the exam, and then we're going to review the sample exam. So that's the basics for taking the exam. Definitely download the testing software. Try out going through the sample exam. Make sure that you can pass that. And if you don't pass it, make sure you go back and figure out why you're not passing it, because sometimes there are some tricky things that they put into the exam to try to stump you. So again, make sure you take the practice exam. Make sure you're comfortable with using equations and linked values, and then go ahead and when you're ready, take the CSWP.